the two of them, they've been trying to have a baby. Martin thinks they are trying. Her husband, he thinks they are trying to have a baby. On, hey God, do you know what? Simi is on the pills because she doesn't want to have a baby, because she wants to still have her career, wants to have her body intact. And then Martin is there thinking maybe he is a problem. He is spending money to go to the hospital for checkups and so many things. Even at the back of the book, the author wrote, "True is company for is trouble." It's true, trouble, wahala. There's a reason. I'm telling you, that book is wahala. Hey guys, hello, hi, welcome back to my channel, and welcome to my channel to all my new subscribers. Hello, thank you for stopping by. My name is Mariam and I am so happy to have you on my channel. Welcome to another Get Ready With Me video, as I talk about the book Wahala by Nikkimay. As you can see today, I kind of like switch it up a little bit. This look was inspired by Sabina Hanan, and I am really, really liking this look. And this is a very simple look because I'm just wearing a veil. And then I tied this hair tie on top, as you can see. And it's actually really nice because I like how we just switched up the whole look. The book Wahala by Nikkimay. This is one book that I enjoyed. It was fun to read. It's such a page turner. It's also a sad book at the same time because I was sad. I was furious. Like, there's some characters when you read it, they're so frustrating. You feel like you just want to go in and smack those characters. We have characters like that almost in every book. So this is one book I enjoyed. I had fun reading. And so I will be wearing my makeup as I talk about the book. I'll just give you guys like a little summary of the book. Let's just get right into the video. Guys, I had to quickly do my eyebrows off camera to save time. So I'll just go ahead now with my foundation. So I'll start with my foundation. So the book Wahala by Nikkimay. It's mostly about three friends. We have Simi, we have Ronke, and we have Boo. And the book was set in England. So, in fact, the three friends, Boo, Simi, and Ronke, they are Anglo-Nigerians. When you hear people say Anglo-Nigerians, it means they are British Nigerians. That is, they're not completely Nigerians either. Maybe their mom is Nigerian or their dad is Nigerian. So yeah, even the author Nikkimay, she is an Anglo-Nigerian. She's British Nigerian. She's not completely Nigerian. Yeah, Ronke is like the main character in the book. Ronke is a dentist. She has a boyfriend called Kayode. Kayode is like this unserious boyfriend who he likes to disappoint. He likes to come up with so many excuses as to why he would not be at a particular place, and then he would send flowers as compensation. Yes, yes. So that is the kind of guy Kayode is. And so all the friends know of Kayode. I don't know what made me. Anyway, this makeup is going to be difficult because of this, but okay. If your friend has a boyfriend like Kayode, of course you'll think he's not the one. Like, why would he be disappointed when you have something very important to do? Okay, he always comes up with an excuse as to he seems like the playboy kind of person. But he seems like the playboy kind of person. I mean, even when I started reading the book, I had a feeling Ronke would end up with Kayode. They're going to break up at some point because of his attitude. But you know what? Just keep listening to know what would happen between Ronke and Kayode. And so they always, the three friends always meet up for lunch to catch up on things. See, that's the problem. When I'm wearing makeup and I'm talking, I tend to do more of the talking and less of the makeup. Simi has this friend, this longtime friend that she lost. They grew up together, and then we all have those friends that we all grew up together. We had childhood friends, and all of a sudden, after somehow we lost contact, and everyone just grew apart. Yes, and so she ran into this friend of hers, Isobel. And so Simi got to meet Isobel and started catching up. Isobel was her childhood friend. They grew up together, they attended the same school. And so they were like, oh wow, long time. So like they were catching up. And so Simi decided to introduce Isobel to her two friends, Boo and Ronke. Ronke at first, she never really liked Isobel because Isobel is this character who she wants to know what is going on in your life. Isobel is so rich. She is so rich. Oh my gosh, she spends a lot. So Isobel comes from a very wealthy home. And so all of a sudden, she wants to be in all the girls, but she wants to know what is happening. And there's always something about that friend that comes and wants to know everything happening in your life. Asking you about your boyfriend, asking you what does he do, what did you guys meet. There's always someone who asks you questions about your partner that you'll be scared for yourself. And Isobel, she came as a character who wanted the best for them. Isobel is no longer together with her partner because her partner, according to her, he is abusive. But they even gave him, what's that thing they call? Where they tell you, don't be around the person for, it's restriction, but then there's something they call it, but it was where they can say, don't be around 100 meters around that person, something like that. Yes. And so Simi is married to Martin. Boo is married to Delia, and she has a daughter called Sophia. So let me hurry and finish applying my foundation, then I'll continue the story. Okay, so even at the back of the book, the author wrote, "True is company for is trouble." It's true, trouble, wahala. There's a reason. You know those people that, let's say for example, among your friends, you guys are three. And so you guys always walk around three, okay? Three friends. When you have more than three friends in a group, it becomes a problem because even among, let's say for example, you guys are five in a group, five friends, there'll be problems, there'll be gossip, there'll be drama because among those five friends, there'll be at least two groups within that five friends. Two would more closer to themselves. There'll be problems, there'll be drama. You guys will be having drama. Every single time there's drama, you guys will be having. The three friends went out for lunch, and then Simi introduced Isobel. You know when you guys are supposed to have lunch together with your friend, and then your friend brings another friend, and you're wondering, wait, we're supposed to be just two. Why are you bringing another friend? I don't know why people do that. For example, why people do that. Just when they say your boyfriend is taking you out for lunch, end up coming with another friend. Did he say he's taking you and your friend out? No, he said you, just you. Don't bring anybody. I feel if I'm going out with someone for lunch or dinner or whatever, even if it's just two of us, me and my friend, if you're coming with an extra friend, tell me that, oh, I'm coming with another person. Oh, are you okay with me coming up with this person? Then just bring the person to the table and tell me, oh, meet my friend as my. And I'll be like, okay, hi, but I'm like, don't get me wrong, I'll be nice to the friend room, but then it's supposed to be just two of us, why are you bringing a third party? Please, you guys, stop doing that. So let me tell you guys Simi's problem. Simi's problem is that she has imposter syndrome. You know, when people, you think, you just feel you don't belong at a particular place. Let's say, for example, you are... Let's say you got invited to dine with King Charles, and then all of a sudden you start feeling, oh my god, I don't belong here. Do I really belong here with all these people? You just feel like you don't belong. That's not what it means to have imposter syndrome. Simi is married to Martin, okay? They've been together. Do you know the two of them, they've been trying to have a baby? Martin thinks they are trying. Her husband, he thinks they are trying to have a baby. Simi is on the pills because she doesn't want to have a baby, because she wants to still have her career, wants to have her body intact. And then Martin is there thinking maybe he is a problem. He is spending money to go to the hospital for checkups and so many things, not knowing Simi is on pills. That is why they've been trying for a baby for a very, very long time. When I read that part, I was like, I was furious with Simi. Like, I should just, like, I should smack. Oh, my. I've heard so many similar stories like that. Okay, let me continue with my concealer. So I just quickly applied my blush. So I told you guys that Martin thinks he and Simi are trying for a baby, but unbeknownst to him, Simi is not trying for a baby because she wants to have her career, she wants to be in shape, and because Boo, her friend, she has the one. I'll get to Boo. Let me just finish with Simi, because Boo is married. She has a daughter, Sophia, and Boo is unhappy. She is stressed. Like, she feels Sophia is draining all her energy, and she doesn't want to be a stay-at-home mom. She wants to be happy. She wants to go out. She wants to have her own life back. But it's just in Boo's head. She has the perfect husband, Dika. He loves her. He helps her with Sophia. Boo is just stressed. I don't know what is wrong, but she's just stressed, unhappy. She is frustrated. And so because of that, Simi doesn't want to have a baby because she feels she doesn't want to be like Boo. Do you guys know there was a time Simi had an abortion because she doesn't want to have a baby? And she didn't even tell Martin about this. I feel this is just so selfish. I've heard stories, similar stories like this. Like real life stories. The story I'm even doubting, like, wait, is this actually true? Is this actually true? Did it actually happen? Do people actually do this? That this woman, she had multiple abortions because she doesn't want to have a baby, and the husband doesn't even know. And somehow he got to know what happened, and she was crying, asking for forgiveness, that she, I don't even know what her excuse was, but it wouldn't pass career, she wants to still be in shape. It's just so selfish of you. Why would you just tell him you don't want to have a baby, other than he keeps trying, spending money, going for checkups, trying different procedures just to have a baby, but then you keep aborting the baby. It's so unfair. Anyway, and so Simi told Isabel about the whole she doesn't want to have a baby, she even aborted her baby. Simi told Isabel that she feels guilty, and guess what? Isabel told her that she should not feel guilty, and so that was how Simi didn't tell Martin. But you know what? Who is married to Didier? Didier is French, and they have a beautiful daughter, Sophia. Oh my god. Boo is just frustrated, unhappy, she is just sad. Oh my god. It's just so sad. And guess what? Do you know Boo cheated on Didier, her husband, with her boss? And guess whose fault? Isabel. Isabel just came into this group to because Isabel is single, and so she wants everyone to be single. She wants to spoil all their relationships. Actually, Isabel came for a revenge. I'll tell you guys about it later. Okay, let me continue with my makeup. So guys, I had to quickly wrap up the makeup so I could just complete the story for you guys. This is just a summary. I'm just giving you guys a summary. This is not the details of everything in the book. I'm giving you guys a summary. And so, on to where I stopped. But I think I like this look. Yeah, what's done? This is 1:42 a.m. I'm not kidding you guys, this is 1:42 a.m. And I am filming by this time. Wow. It's sad that I'm going to have to clean this makeup to sleep. Oh, see my hand. Look at my hand. People, at some point, she became so obsessed with Isabel. He's always, Isabel said this, Isabel said that. Well, they went to Isabel. This is Isabel. And so at some point, she was just kind of just tolerating her husband. And meanwhile, Roncaire wanted everything Boo had. She wanted a husband, she wanted a child. Roncaire wanted a family. Do you guys know there's something about the guilt? When you're guilty about something, there's a way you behave. Okay, let's say for example now. I think that's why people used to say, for example, people say something, they'd be like, look at me in the eye and tell me what you said. Or they'll say, look at me in the eye and repeat what you said. If you can't look at them in the eye, meaning you're lying. But we have some bold-faced liars who would look at you in the eyes and the eyeballs and they'll still lie in your face. But then if you have conscience, you may not be able to look at the person directly in the eye because you're just feeling guilty for what you did. So Boo came back from the trip. She was feeling guilty. She couldn't even look at her husband in the eye. At the end, she found out that it wasn't worth it. Husband found out what happened via her email because she didn't even delete her emails. So he found out, but thank God Boo was able to, she told Isabel that, listen, let's just stop this whole thing. I need to focus on my husband. And but thank God Boo realized the whole Isabel situation, but too late because the deal has been done. But let me go back to Roncaire. So Roncaire and her boyfriend Kion, they, hey. So at some point, they're looking for an apartment to do all moving together. Kylie dated Isabel at some point, but they even almost got married, but they didn't. And then Isabel dragged Kylie all over South Africa. He had to leave, she had to his job. And so he kept telling Roncaire, stay away from Isabel, she's evil. But then I think the reason why Roncaire didn't show it because she was curious to know why is it that Kylie keeps saying stay away from Roncaire, stay away from Roncaire. Okay, let me tell you guys something. It turns out Boo and Isabel are half sisters, but Boo doesn't know, but Isabel knows. It turns out that Roncaire's dad was going out with Isabel's mom, and so because Isabel's dad is so wealthy, he got Roncaire's dad killed. Okay, he got Roncaire's dad killed, but Roncaire still doesn't know about all of this. But then Isabel knew. That's why I said Isabel came for a revenge. Boo's dad, who is also Isabel's dad, he was with her mom for a short period of time, got mom pregnant. And then he left, and so the whole situation was planned and arranged. Why I also said it was planned because before Isabel got in contact with Simi, she saw their pictures on Facebook. That was how she got to know, and she even knew Coyote already because I mean she recognized him obviously because they kind of dated. She recognized Coyote, she recognized Simi, and then she had her own plans, and that was why she was on her own mission to come and destroy the friendship. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of all mixed up like that. Yeah. Okay, Roncaire didn't know this was actually what happened, that her dad was killed. She thought it was a carjack, but it was not. It was actually arranged that dad will die. But she always knew that her dad was perfect. To her eyes, her dad was the perfect dad ever. Like, her dad was so perfect that, and she really, really loved her dad. And she didn't even date any other, like, she has a preference to date only black men. I know some people have preference when it comes to dating. They will say they only like to date fair girls. Some will say they only like tall guys, fair guys, dark guys. Everyone have his or her own preference. And because Ronke adores her dad, she dates only black men. But then her mom knew what the dad did. Her mom got angry. But the dad, he's a twin. So his twin sister is so close to Ronke. Book is Wahala. End of the story. Simi's husband Martin, he came back and he found out that Simi was in the pill, and he even found out that she had an abortion. Okay, he got angry, he left. They have been talking for some days. Anyway, at the end of the story, they got back together. At the end of the story, also, Boo was able to, I think Boo and her husband were able to work things out in their marriage. At the end, this is the saddest part of the thing for me. You guys know, Isabel was so jealous. She didn't want Coyote, because Coyote actually really, really liked Ronke. He wanted things to work out with Ronke. But then, Isabel told Ronke that, oh, Coyote is making advances on her. Likes her, da, 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 da. But Kaide was trying to make things clear with Isabel. Please, I really want things to work out with Ronke. Then, unfortunately, do you guys know Isabel killed Kaide at the end of the book? They went to Isabel's house because he wanted to really make things work out with him and Ronke. But then Isabel, she killed him in cold blood, although she lied that he first attacked her, trying to kill her, but then she killed him in self-defense, which we know is a lie. But then she was just jealous that Coyote wanted to get serious with Ronke, trying to destroy the whole relationship. And she killed him. Do you know, I couldn't believe she actually did that. And guess what? She went free. Okay? They couldn't pin murder on her because there was no evidence. She got away with it. That's the end of my video. I didn't give you guys the whole details of what actually happened. But that is the summary of the book, of what the book is about. It's a really nice book. I'd like you guys to check it out. You guys should read it. Wahala by Nikki May. This book is Wahala, it's trouble. They say three is company, four is trouble. This book, so much Wahala in this book. Anyway, thank you guys for watching my video. If you have been watching my video up to this minute, please give me a thumbs up so I can know that you have been here with me the whole time. Thank you guys for watching my video. Thank you guys so much. If you enjoyed my video, please give me a thumbs up. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.